I receive a lot of questions about add-ons in a Blender. Almost below each of my TikTok and YouTube videos, you ask me which add-on I used in this art. So today I will show you my main pack of Blender add-ons, which helps me create digital arts. I'm Slavo, I'm digital artist, and I welcome you to my channel. Today I have this digital art and it helps me clearly show which add-ons I usually use in my works. Now, this is dramatic landscape, absolutely simple, but let's take a closer look and we start with the first add-on which I use for landscape. Another noise tool, landscape. This is standard Blender add-on which you can find, just go to the preferences, add-ons and type landscape. When you turn on this add-on in the preferences, you can find this add-on in the create folder, just press N or press Shift A and find landscape in the mesh. Add landscape to the scene and open settings. The add-on has amazing presets like mountains, dunes, rivers and even rocks, which will be enough for a lot of projects, but if you need some special, you can adjust all the settings to achieve desirable result. So I am preparing several different mountains for my art, just changing random seed. Add a new one landscape, leave all settings as before, just change random seed and get another mountain. Then I use these mountains to create my main mountain background in the art. Move and adjust to interesting horizon shape. Using this add-on I also create the ground, just using presets large terrain. It's pretty enough for me with default settings. Also I use this add-on for this ground surface here, but in another way. I create a standard landscape and adjust the size. Press Shift Tab and choose sculpt mode. Now I use this mesh and sculpting mode in a Blender to create surface as I need in my art. When I work with the landscape, I do sculpting a lot. Mountains, rocks, ground, everything. But the huge problem of sculpting is topology. If you are using dynamic topology or doing remesh, you may know it creates soil density topology, and make unwrap using this topology is almost impossible. So we need to optimize this mesh and then work with the textures. And Quad Remesher will help me. This is the second add-on that I use after I sculpt environment elements. This add-on automatically creates mesh and gray topology for your object, making quad polygons. Just pick the necessary object, open Quad Remesher and press Remesh it. If necessary, you may increase quad count or decrease it and get different level of density, depending on your situation and how you want to use your model. For background, it's not necessary to use soil density mesh and I can use the default value. This add-on creates a copy of your object, which means you will never mess up your main model, and also if you need to make a normal map from your high poly model, you can do it. Or if you don't like the density of the mesh, you may delete them and change setting and press remesh it again. Now I can easily make unwrap for all mountains using standard unwrap in Blender. As you see, Quad Remesher created a nice topology and they have nice UVs ready to texturing. Next add-ons is two my favorite add-ons, Cracker and One Click Damage. Both of them would help you if you want to create some ruins or ancient architecture. So I have this destroyed tower in the middle of my scene and let's make it more interactive. First I'm going to use Cracker add-on for slice geometry and to make crackers in the wall. After you install the add-on, pick an object and press Ctrl W. In the left corner you may find hints on how to use this add-on. Briefly, it slices geometry into pieces, but you may impact this process and move this line, rotate or adjust the wave, just use your middle button on the mouse. Next I pick another piece and slice again. Of course we can use the self-fracture add-on, which is standard add-on of the Blender, and make this process automatically. But Cracker has one big advantage, you can divide geometry as you need. one big piece, another small, and create everything as you wish as an author of your art. So, when we subdivided our geometry into different pieces, it's time to make a damage stone. For this, I open the one-click damage add-on. This is absolutely simple add-on that has two settings and two noise types, which allows you to adjust the scale and the amount of texture. Don't forget to press apply. One thing that you should know is that depending on the size of your object, settings will affect the object differently. If you have one large object and the other small, then the same settings will work differently, then you need to adapt it. But for object which has the same size, you can do everything only by selecting object and click apply. First creating damage structure. Alright, we reviewed add-ons for modeling and let's go to light. I already have a video about lights and I pay a lot of attention to the light in my arts. If you wanna know more about light, welcome to other videos. But in this video, I wanna look at one of the amazing add-ons for light in a blender, is physical starlight and atmosphere. This add-on allows you to create atmospheric light without using HDRI or something else. Also, the add-on can add procedural clouds, stars and fog, which will be added automatically to each material, creating atmospheric haze in your art. Using physical starlight and atmosphere add-on, you can create an atmospheric environment, alien planets and sci-fi landscape easily. If we're talking about landscapes, digital arts and concepts, so we need scatter to add grass, trees and other environment props. In this art I don't have a forest, but I add some grass here and here. I wanted to show this grass grow in these cracks in the soil where we can see some flames. For this purpose I always use Geo Scatter, which allows me to create a scatter system. One thing that I definitely like more, it creates a texture map to impact where I want to see this grass. It works this way. I open color masks and turn on image, create a new black color texture and add this texture as a mask on the scatter. As we see, all grass was disappeared. But I go to the texture paint, painting the area where I want to see this grass. Here and in this place, also maybe here. As we see now, grass is growing where I paint the white mask. Also, we can draw a mask using vertex paint, but it works if you have a more density of mesh. I always use both ways depending on the situation. Also, the add-on can do random scale and rotation, so everything that your grass or forest looks realistic. If you have a large landscape or don't have a powerful PC, turn on display earth and everything will be turned into simple boxes or other shapes. Absolutely necessary add-on for landscape, concepts and arts. Finally, we need to add some details. We need 3D models. And I have two interesting add-ons. First, it's Botaniq, which has realistic trees, grass, plants and more interesting stuff for environment artists. As for me, the most interesting things here is that the add-on has trees for summer and winter. I need a tree without leaves and it's a good fit for me. Pick some kind of this tree, but we need to convert it to the table because this tree with no material and I need to remove this effect. By default you can't edit materials of plants from Botaniq add-on, but can convert it to the table. In material, I remove snow amount to zero and this one is what I need in this scene. Just move this one in my scene. Of course, we can use scatter for this, but I guess it's not so hard to move and rotate a couple of trees. So I do this without scattering, just copy a couple of them and move in the necessary position. Okay, the next add-on is the Blender Kit. I use models from the Blender Kit in each of my projects. It's an absolutely necessary tool for artists. There are free and paid plans, but I really recommend use the full plan that you will have all models from the base. In this scene, I wanted some roots and rocks, so type roots. There are a lot of models of roots and trunks. I would be using maybe this one. Yeah, just click, drag and drop into the scene. Wait while it downloads, and I can use this one in my art. Everything happens in a blender. The add-on has different categories of models. You can search by name or by categories. So let's try stones. Maybe this one. I guess it's pretty fit for my context. In the full library, as you see here, plenty of models, different models. If you work with commercial project, it's must have. Perhaps add-ons in a blender are the very first reason why artists love Blender, because add-ons make our lives very easily. Especially when geometry nodes in a blender was released, there were a lot of add-ons working on geometry nodes, which generally expand the base of interesting add-ons. It's enough to look at the Blender market on GitHub, where you can find many add-ons for modeling, animation, and other purposes. For almost every task, there is an add-on that will simplify your life and help to make the work faster. In one video, impossible to tell everything. Today we have reviewed the main add-ons for Blender that I use in almost every project, which are the main setup for me. But there are many add-ons that I use one time or only in some cases. In my Discord server, I made a section where I will distribute a lot of necessary for work in a Blender and the add-ons that I find interesting for work. So subscribe to my Discord, subscribe to my YouTube channel, share this video with your friends, and I would be glad to see which add-ons you use in the comment section below. See you in the next one.